Hi everyone! I already posted a pre-recorded video discussion about the introduction and assumptions of art. This time, let's move on to the elements of visual arts. Taking off from the scientific reference, elements of art are similar to the atoms that are defined as the units or building blocks of matter. Together in a variation of combinations and formations, they have the ability to create molecules such as water and more complex sucrose. These formulations are almost the same with the elements of art. In the same line of reasoning, the elements of art are the aspects of an artwork that can be isolated from each other. In other words, the elements of visual arts are the basics or the foundations in creating an artwork, specifically a visual artwork. These elements are generally produced when something is done to the medium after the technique is carried out. It must be underscored, however, that all works of art require all elements to be present. Some art forms also necessitate some of the elements as they are inherent in the very nature of them. Meaning to say, in creating an artwork or in an artwork, if not most, all of the elements are present. To enumerate the elements of art and design, here are the following. We have the line, the shape, the form, the space, color, and texture. First, let's have the line. A line refers to a point moving at an identifiable path. It has length and direction. It also has width. Although a line is simple, it has variations in view of its orientation, direction, shape, and thickness. Kung imong nahunaon, simple ra kayo ng linya, pila na may pagamag linya. But, magkalain-lain ang lines because of its direction, asa siya padong, its shape, the shape of the lines, and the thickness. These variations import not only the visual elements into the artwork, but it suggests meaning and message being conveyed by the artist. So here are the different types of lines. First, we have horizontal and vertical lines. Simple ni siya kaayo, pero daghan kong kailang maglibog unsay vertical, unsay horizontal. Okay, maglibog sila. Asa may nagtindugan na? Si vertical ba? Kasi may naghigdaan na? Si horizontal ba? Okay, like this and like that. So, to clarify everything, kanang nagtindog, okay, that is vertical line. Kanang naghigda parallel to the ground, or kanang pinahigda siya landscape ang iyang feature, that is the horizontal line. I hope dili mo maglibog, ana. When you use horizontal lines in an artwork, they are normally associated with rest and calm. Okay? Rest and calm na ang iyahang dating, it's because they move parallel to the ground. Vertical lines, on the other hand, connote elevation or height since nagtindog man siya, which is usually taken for mean exaltation or aspiration for action. Together, kung tapuon ni sila nga lines, they communicate stability and firmness. Next types of lines are diagonal and crooked lines. Diagonal lines convey movement and instability, although the progression can be seen. Crooked lines are also known as the zigzag. Why does these lines convey movement and instability? Well, if you try to notice a diagonal line, di ba nakatakilid man siya gamay, okay? Muraragod po rin na to kung magbalancing ta, then balancing ka, dapat magtuliid ka. And then, kung outbalance ka, meaning dili ka stable, unstable ka, munang mo takilid ka gamay. Pwede ang porma sa diagonal. So, munang mag-convey siya og instability. For the crooked lines, as you can see, crooked lines are diagonal lines connected with each other. So, inga na iyahang look like. Munang, the moment na magsikag-connect, magkataas imuhang crooked lines, it conveys movement. Meaning, moving siya. The third types of lines are curved lines. These are lines that bend or coil. The sample picture here is an example of a bended curved line. So, how does coiled curved line look like? Well, if you try to imagine a nilambid or shakoy, okay? So, kana bitaw mo siya gisintipid or gibraid. So, mao na ang coiled curved line. So this type of lines, they allude to softness, grace, flexibility, or even sensuality. Lines may not necessarily be explicit or literally shown, as what many examples will portray, implied lines may be just as powerful. Simple or kahit tanawon or nahunaon ang lines, but if they are put together, they create a powerful or a beautiful art piece. Now, let's move on to another elements of visual arts. We have shape and form. These two elements are related to each other in the sense that they define the space occupied by the object of an art. For two dimensions, shape refers to height and width. But for three dimensions, shape refers to height, width, and depth. There are two categories that can be used as a broad distinction for shape and form. First, we have the geometric. This shape finds origin in mathematical propositions. As such, its translation and use are often man-made. These shapes include squares, triangles, cubes, circles, spheres and cones, and unsa pa nauban diha nga naa sa ato ang mathematics, nga mga shapes nga nasa ato mathematics. As you can see in the picture on the right side, so mo na siya nga mga shapes ang under geometric. While the second category is the organic shape. Organic shapes are those readily occurring in nature, often irregular and asymmetrical. Meaning to say, dili siya as in emphasize, dili siya unlike sa mga parallelogram, unlike sa mga pentagon, yan na dili siya ideal nga mga corners, ideal nga mga porma. Now let's move on to the fourth element, which is space. Related to shape and form is space. It is usually inferred from a sense of depth, whether it is real or simulated. Real space is three-dimensional. Like what has been previously mentioned, sculptures are a perfect example of artworks that bear this element. However, not all works are sculptures. In two-dimensional artworks, they may be implied by the following. First, let's have the positive and the negative space. So this space usually identified with the white space in the negative space. So the positive space, on the other hand, is the space where shadow is heavily used. In the sample picture on the right side, you can see the drawing with a black and white feature. As I've said, the positive space is the space where the shadow is heavily used. Meaning to say, kanang naka-black, mauna siya ang positive nga space. The next type of space is the three-dimensional space. It can be simulated through a variety of techniques such as shading. An illusion of three-dimensionality can be achieved in two-dimensional work. So, sa gingon na ako ganina nga, when you say three-dimensional, it refers to an artwork or a piece of art nga na ay height, width, and depth. As you can see in the picture on the right side sa three-dimensional space, mura kag nasa reality. Nagama siyog illusion nga murag naa ka sa area. Makita nimo nga naay floor, naay wall, naay ceiling. Now let's have the fifth element, which is color. Color is perhaps one of the elements that enhances the appeal of an artwork. You try to compare an artwork nga walay color versus an artwork nga naay color or colorful. So you can really see life and beauty sa naay color. Maka-enhance siya sa quality or appearance sa imuhang art. The color wheel corresponds to the first property of color. In the color wheel, we have this term, hue. This dimension of color gives its name. It can be subdivided into three. We have the primary colors, secondary colors, and tertiary colors. So primary colors are the very basic color. So all of the other colors nagikan na sila ani nga mga kolora. We have color red, color yellow, and color blue. So mao na sila ang primary colors. How about secondary colors? So kung i-combine nimo tong mga primary colors, ma-create ni sila secondary colors. So if you combine color red and color yellow, you can create color orange. If you combine color blue and color yellow, you can create color green. And if you combine color red and color blue, you can create color violet. Meaning to say, green, orange, and violet are the secondary colors, while the tertiary colors are 6 in total. 6 na sila kabuok. These colors or hues are achieved when primary and secondary colors are mixed. Kung itipo ang secondary color o ang primary color, mo ni na si tertiary color. For example, itipo ni mo si yellow o si green. So, you have yellow-green. If imong tipoon si red o si orange, you can create color red-orange and blue-violet. So, daghan pa na siya, 6 na sila kabuok. So, mauna siya ang tertiary colors. Now, let's move on to another dimension of color, which is value. Value refers to the brightness and darkness of color. Often, this is used by artists to create the illusion of depth and solidity, a particular mood, communicate a feeling, or in establishing a scene, whether it is a night scene or a day scene. Light colors in the color wheel are used or taken as the source of light in the composition. Kung magamit og light sa isa ka artwork, so mao na siya ang source of light anang a piece of work. While if you are using dark colors, so mao na siya ang lack or even absence of light, mao na ang pwede ka mag ngon nga gabi na siyang scene. Next dimension, we have intensity. Intensity is the color's brightness or dullness. It is identified as the strength of color, whether it is vivid or muted. To achieve a specific intensity of a color, one may add either gray or its complementary color. Kung si value nag-identify og darkness and lightness, intensity identifies brightness and dullness. So, nayuban nga siga kayo nga color, napuyuban nga patay ra kayo nga color. Bright or warm colors convey positive energy, while dull or cool colors, sedate or soothing, and serious or calm. To better understand intensity of color, color harmonies are to be considered. In interior design, we often hear designers refer to color schemes. So, color schemes are guide for selecting not only wall paint but also furniture and decor. However, color harmonies are also integral considerations not only for pictorial arts but also for other forms of art. First, we have the monochromatic harmonies. So, monochromatic harmonies use the variations of a hue. What have you observed in the picture on the right side? Okay. So, based on the definition of a monochromatic harmony, it uses variations of a hue. In that picture, they use the variation of color blue. So, tanang colors nga gigamit sa ilahang artwork is color blue. Lain-lain lang siya og intensity. Okay? So, we have navy blue, we have royal blue, the natural blue, the sky blue, baby blue, and so on and so forth. So, that is monochromatic harmony. It uses the variation of a hue or a color. Next, we have complementary harmonies. Complementary harmonies involve two colors opposite to each other in the color wheel. Since they are contrary positions, the reaction is most intense. An example picture on the right side uses the color orange and the color blue. If you try to look at the color wheel, they are opposite to each other. Their position is opposite to each other. And lastly, we have the analogous harmony. So, analogous harmony make use of two colors beside each other in the color wheel. Meaning to say, ang gigamit nga colors sa artwork are the colors na nagtapad sa color wheel. In the example here, we have color yellow-green and yellow. So, if you have noticed in the color wheel, nagtapad rin na sila. So, that is an analogous harmony. The sixth and the last visual element of art is texture. Like space, texture can be either real or implied. This element in an artwork is experienced through the sense of touch, but sometimes it can also be experienced through the sense of sight. kung real ang artwork, meaning to say, ma-feel ni mo siya through the sense of touch nga. Uy, hagasa siya, uy, hamay siya. But if it is implied, meaning to say, if nagtanaw ra ka o picture, okay, based on the construction or the art nga gi-apply or element nga gi-apply na, ma-feel ni mo while watching that specific art piece kung hagasas ba siya, kung hamis ba siya, and so on and so forth. That's it. Let's all remember that the elements of art make it possible to engage with the visual and tactile qualities of the artwork through a common language that they may be widely understood. Through these elements, there is something from which the idea, concept, message, or intended mode of the artist may be inferred. It offers a starting point or a baseline from which analysis may take place. This kind of analysis is called the formal analysis of art. And that ends the discussion for today. Thank you so much for watching and hope you've learned. If you have questions and clarifications, don't forget to notify me in the established messenger group chat or you can comment here in this video. Bye!